Are you using a docking station or USB-C power source to charge your laptop? Have you ever wondered how that works or whether that's a concern with keeping it charging all the time? In this video, I'd like to address some common questions we receive about laptop charging and provide you with best practices for keeping your laptop powered, whether at home or at a business setup. One question we often get is whether it's safe to leave your computer connected to a dock to charge for extended periods, such as overnight. The answer is yes. Plugable and most other docking stations that are able to charge compatible computers do so over a standard called USB-C power delivery, or PD for short. You can think of power delivery as sort of an intelligent negotiation process between the computer and the docking station, where the computer actually communicates with the power source to draw only the power it requires. This is a dynamic process, meaning as the battery depletes or fills up, the laptop will request more or less power. Let's walk through an example. Here is a MacBook Pro that only has about 50% battery remaining. I also have our pluggable UD OldC4K docking station with me, which supports up to 100 watts of charging. With the help of our pluggable USB-C power meter, the USB-C VA meter 3, to measure wattage and flow of electrical current, let's see what happens when I connect the Mac to the dock. Upon connection, we see the Mac initially pull a low amount of power, but after a moment, it charges at approximately 50 watts. The laptop recognizes its battery is low and pulls more power to charge more quickly. Now, here's another Mac with almost full battery, about 95% charged. Notice how when I connect it to the dock, the Mac requests significantly less power, only about 20 watts. As the battery nears full capacity, the laptop reduces its charging rate to minimize unnecessary degradation of the battery. You can also see how this concept applies similarly when the laptop is set to sleep. Notice how after I've set the computer to sleep, it is now pulling less than 10 watts. Since the computer isn't doing much at all in sleep mode and also has a full battery, it doesn't need a lot of power to maintain its charge and therefore charges very slowly. So you can see that the dock isn't blindly pushing 100 watts of power to the computer, but instead the computer is pulling only the power it needs, depending on the battery level and system load. As a best practice, if you expect to keep your laptop charging a majority of the time and would like to optimize battery health for the long term, you may want to consider setting the upper charge limit of the battery to 80% or less. This is because lithium-ion batteries stored at a greater charge will degrade faster than batteries stored at a lower charge. Most laptop manufacturers like Apple, Lenovo, or HP provide battery management software or a BIOS setting option to limit the maximum charge capacity. But in summary, you don't need to worry about leaving your laptop docked and charging for too long or overcharging the battery. Thanks to USB-C PD, as well as the computer's built-in battery charging controller and software, the computer can maintain the battery's optimal state and prevent overcharging scenarios, even when connected to a power source for an extended period of time. Hopefully that helps you understand more about USB-C charging when it comes to docking stations. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment below. Thanks.